If that's not an example, if that's not a sign that something's wrong, majorly wrong, then maybe whoever thinks that's not a problem or to leave this country, go to another country where they accept setting yourself on fire. No Americans could ever come back and have to travel 100 miles to get health care. We're in a position now to let them travel 100 yards. They earned it. They deserve it.
I'm sure that Tuesday when I take the oath of office with my family, remembering my late parents, my late brother, that will be an emotional moment, but I'm sure it'll be more emotional than this. So thank you for welcoming us here today. And as I always do when I'm around either active duty or veterans, I feel incredibly inadequate. So I'm incredibly humbled that you all would have me today with my family. Joe, I thank you for your work, your passion, your kind introduction. I've gotten to know you over the past couple of years. I've had the chance to go on your show several times now, as has Tammy, and I've greatly enjoyed our discussions on how we all can be stronger advocates for our veterans. And I'll talk about Jeff in a second, but that ranking of 50 out of 50 is a bone in my throat. I know it is in all of our throats, so we're going to fix that. But Joe, I thank you for always fighting for our veterans. I started for their care. This past fall, AtlantiCare Hospital in Atlantic City announced a first in the nation partnership with the VA for veterans to have access to their services rather than having to travel out of state. That is an innovative and common sense solution. And I know that more solutions are out there that we can implement to help enhance care for every veteran in every county. We will and we must do a better job of partnering with the institutions and groups that allow veterans to transition to successful civilian lives. That includes employers, universities, and mental health agencies, among others. We will ensure better outreach to veterans so more know about the benefits they earned and are qualified for. One of the early aha's that we all had was there's a lot of stuff out there that folks can't find. There's no one database where you can look up if I live in this county or this community. We have to do a better job of that. And we will. These are difficult issues. I don't want to make any bones about that. And I will be open and we will be open to ideas from everywhere because veterans know veterans' issues best. And one of the big regrets in my life, I think at the top of the list, that I did not serve in our military. So we defer not just to the veterans and heroes in this room, but around the state. You deserve a seat at the table and you will have one.
Thank you very much for having us. God bless our veterans, our Vietnam veterans, and our veterans of all wars. And God bless our active duty members. And thank you so much for your family here this morning.
Thank you for coming.
Thank you. Love you, buddy.